MS-DOS stands for Microsoft Disk Operating System, or simply called DOS. This name feels quite familiar to our head, especially for those who live in the 80s and 90s and using an IBM PC or its compatible hardware. From its first release back in 1981, through all phases and falls until its discontinuation in 2000 due to graphical user interfaces are way ahead to the society. To find out how it got recognized by so many people to be a living memory by those who goes with it, let's take a look at its development throughout the time. In April 1980, CPM was the leading market for operating system. It inherits the designs from PDP-11 operating system. Intel is about to release their next processor, 8086. Manufacturers are in dire need for an operating system for it, since CPM-86, a version of CPM for 8086, was delayed many times. The guy from SCP, well, not that SCP, but this SCP, Seattle Computer Products, Tim Patterson, along with his team, started to work out on an operating system for that said processor. From that idea, QDOS was born, stands for Quick and Dirty Operating System. It was written on a Chromemso Z80 computer running Chromemso CDOS, in a text editing software called MicroPro WordMaster. It was then translated using a Z80 to 8086 translator called Trans86, which was later ported to 86DOS and renamed to simply just Trans, and tested on the Seattle Computer Products 16-bit computer system. In July, Tim decided to quickly release the operating system since it's more comprehensible choice than constantly adding features while the OS isn't been released yet, resulting on QDOS 0.10, which was built on July 1980. This is the first beta build of QDOS with its half-complete state, and only 10 people have seen this build. It was a preliminary release with commands crammed into a 6 kilobyte project code. It's using the modified version of Basic 86 FAT file system with 12-bit table elements, supports allowing 64 megabyte disks with 8.3 file naming system, which was adopted from CPM. Commands are split into two categories: internal, which is a command that isn't available in the root directory as a file, such as stir, rename, erase, copy, and type. And then there is external, which is a command that exists as a .com file in a root directory such as ASM, trans, and hex2bin. An unspecified bug was found in the build, resulting in a newer build, QDOS 0.11, which also never shipped outside of SCP. The next version, 86DOS 0.20, is the first public release of 86DOS. The naming is still unknown whether it's QDOS 0.20 or 86DOS 0.20. It introduced many changes on the internal side. The most noticeable changes is the inclusion of Edlin, A, and the line editor for 86DOS that was expected to only last for 6 months, but it's actually supported up to MS-DOS 5.0 and Windows NT versions up to Windows 10. Tim called Edlin as the quote-unquote quickest line editor I could imagine. It also has several additions to commands such as clear, rdcpm, and sys. This version of 86DOS, also known to be the version that shipped with low masses LDP88 and LDP72. While it's not fully confirmed, this version is also known to be the one that was originally licensed to Microsoft. Paul Allen called Rod Brock that they have an anonymous customer interested to sublicense 86DOS, which results in a verbal agreement.
So basically you're saying you want to buy my operating system?
Yeah.
Why?
You know, I don't know. We just think we might be able to, you know, mess with it and resell it.
Who to?
We have a few customers, you know, we're sort of talking to. Some of them don't really want it known what we're doing with them. So they made us sign a secrecy agreement.
And you're offering us?
$50,000.
Dollars?
Dollars. 0.3 is an alleged unreleased beta version with not much known for its existence aside from a license agreement documentation between Microsoft and SAP in which Microsoft suggests some addition to 86 DOS such as data buffer to be input on user startup, which eventually added later on, and several others. This version, oftenly mislabeled as either 0.33 or 0.34 in several sources such as Tim's A Short History of MS-DOS and 0.3's manual. 0.33 adds debug for debugging purpose with marked CPM and CHKDS key added as an external command. Barry Watzman owned and sold SCP floppy disks, including 86 DOS 0.33 disks, according to a conversation at comps.os.cpm. 0.34 didn't include significant changes, but version 0.60, an unreleased version, features a new I/O system. On April 31, 1981, 86 DOS 1.0 was released with many features and changes added to the OS, such as more detailed in the with modification state and exact file size displayed for each file, batch file support, double density floppy disk support, and so many others. It was shipped on a single-sided 8-inch floppy disk and available to several OEMs. Aside from that, one of the downsides of this version requires you to manually input a date each time you turn on the machine, and it cannot be skipped. The other problem is that everything is saved on a root directory and no subdirectory or folder support currently present, leaving every program's documents and projects saved entirely on a root directory. The next released version of 86 DOS 1.10 brought some changes such as EXE support, file attribution support to hide files such as 86DOS.sys, which is the DOS kernel file replacing the small reserved sectors. This is the first version of 86 DOS that was actually bought by Microsoft and was rebranded to MS-DOS eventually. Several unreleased versions of 86 DOS was later built before the last version to bear the 86 DOS name, 1.14, which emphasizes the use of 86DOS.sys as a DOS kernel file as the reserved space on a disk is no longer fit to put it on. Strangely enough, if no date was inputted, upon a boot, it shows the date as 00001980, which is apparently Sunday. Unreleased builds are now built under the MS-DOS name now. While there's small changes from the one build to another, MS-DOS 1.23 is allegedly the first known build to be released to several OEM, as a known evaluation copy was discovered, which was licensed to American Science, Energy and Environment. MS-DOS 1.24, however, a version base for IBM's PC-DOS 1.10, introduces both single-sided and double-sided 5.25-inch floppy disk support. The last released MS-DOS 1.x family, 1.25, brought final changes to the OS such as additional command.com command support such as ports and RAM. This is the first version to be shipped with non-IBM OEMs, resulting in some different compiled versions. Microsoft at this point is making a newer version of MS-DOS rather than an updated version of 1.25 by constantly adding significant changes to each build, including vir command support, mkdir, chdir, pwd, and rmdir commands were added, resulting in a release of MS-DOS 2.0, which introduces subdirectories and up to 10 MB hard drive support. This is a significant game changer for Microsoft, as their MS-DOS product is close to be usable enough for general use. Along the release of 2.x MS-DOS family, it brought many broader variety of its use, such as CLS and ECO support, international support via country command under config.sys, Japanese kanji character support up to 7,000 characters. OEM also received a version of 2.x such as 2.01 for Wang, 2.05 for DEC Rainbow, Eagle and Compaq. On August 1984, Microsoft released MS-DOS 3.0. It brings FAT16 support, which partitions up to 32 MB, 5.25 1.2 MB floppy disk, and a more improved internal clock. 3.10 released later on with LAN support, 3.20 with 3.5 double density 720 kilobyte floppy disk support, 3.21 brings IBM enhanced and convertible keyboard support, 3.30 introduced 1.44 megabyte floppy disk support, extended support for select, and the last version is 3.31 with FAT16 support for larger than 32 megabytes partitions. An update for 3.x family, labeled as 3.40, is mentioned in several documentations such as Serbian Computer Magazine, Svet Computera, and a contract between Microsoft and Zenith from August 1987. The final decision puts down the MS-DOS 3.40 name and taking the 4.0 to the surface with EGA and VGA display adapter support, graphic printing was added, LIM or EMS standard support, various new features in commands such as tree, delete, mode, append, fast open, NLS, PUNC, attribute, fdisk, replace, backup, graph table, etc. But the most noticeable features out of the version is the introduction of MS-DOS shell that makes the users capable to do more power with file management. Well, the major bugs in the shell and in the memory management system, producing an update dubbed MS-DOS 4.01 in November 1988. A few years later, in 1991, Microsoft released the next family of MS-DOS, 5.x. Started as 5.0 with Edlin replaced by Edit. A new setup procedure replaces Select. 5.00a with the lowercase a fixed bugs and pertaining format and fdisk commands. 5.00a with the uppercase a only released for Japanese NEC PC98X1 series, while 5.00A-H was bundled with NEC PC-98X1 series and never shipped as a retail release. Keeping the tradition of introducing a new family for MS-DOS, Microsoft releases MS-DOS 6.x family that starts on March 1993. The first version, 6.00, introduced disk defragmenter, disk compression with double space, antivirus with MWAV, a new backup system, and a PC-to-PC file transfer tools. An issue including the compression was made due to the fault of double space. 6.20 brings scan disks and disk copy, and improved smart drive. This 6.x family seems to not be nice at all the time. 6.21 released as a result of legal conjunction by Stack Electronics over the use of stack code in double space and removes the double space from the OS. 6.22 from June 1994 is the last version of MS-DOS to be truly shipped as a standalone product with all enhanced tools and bring previously removed tools as a separate disk named Supplemental Disk, including Edlin. But the legal trouble didn't stop there. The digital research founder, Gary Kildall, examined PC-DOS and found that it copied CPM's programming interfaces. He wanted to sue IBM, which claimed PC-DOS at the time, but digital research's attorney cannot found a relevant law enough to sue about. But nonetheless, Kildall did confront IBM and persuaded them to offer CPM86 as a bundle with their PC in exchange to the release of liability. But it doesn't end up just there. The heat becomes bigger when Jerry Purnell said that Kildall personally demonstrated him that DOS contained CBM code by entering an unknown command to reveal Kildare's name. Think of it like just an Easter egg. But the claim wasn't really strong enough because he never revealed the command. A 2004 book, They Made America, by Harold Evans, he sued the Evans and the publisher for the alleged defamation, but the court ruled that no defamation occurred as the book's claims were opinions based on research or were not probably false. MS-DOS 7.0 is a version of MS-DOS integrated to Windows 95, which brings long file name support and a splash screen. MS-DOS 7.0 is a version integrated to Windows 95 OSR 2.x and Windows 98, and it has FAT32 support. An unofficial rig pack of MS-DOS subsystem in Windows 98 was made by China DOS Union in 2003 and often mislabeled as the true MS-DOS 7.0. The last version of MS-DOS 8.0 is integrated in Windows ME with a less prominent function to Windows and later on. This version of MS-DOS is the one that used for startup disk format option in Windows XP through Windows 8.1. Starting from the late 80s onwards, people started to use resources even more, while MS-DOS is still stuck at 640K maximum RAM, limited graphical interface, and many other aspects leading to people slowly discontinuing MS-DOS in favor of other interfaces such as Windows, Macintosh, GEM, etc. Microsoft and IBM was also did a joint development on an X operating system named OS 2, but later on split it in separate ways to develop their own OS. IBM continuing OS 2, while Microsoft working on a new operating system named Windows, which later on integrates MS-DOS function into it. Even though MS-DOS is not technically supported by Microsoft by today's standard, many efforts from the communities started to resurrect DOS from its grave. An open source project named FreeDOS was made in 1998 in response to the cancellation. As of the video's production time, the latest version of it, FreeDOS 1.3, still retains compatibility down to the old 8086 system while still making your system compatible for the operating system. Some modern laptops still shipped with variant of FreeDOS as an alternative to Windows. Microsoft eventually open-sourced the MS-DOS version 1.25 and 2.11 to Computer History Museum in 2014, followed by GitHub with MIT license in 2018. A yearly four-month event known as DOSember served its purpose to pay a tribute to MS-DOS. A spiritual successor of MS-DOS, Command Prompt, retained in Windows as a compatibility and several functionality purposes. But at the end of the day, MS-DOS may have gone from our life, but its spirit still lives on through the eternity.